Hello, class of 2021. We did it. I want to say thank you to all my teachers, friends, and family members who helped me get to where I'm at. Today is one of the most biggest days of our life. I am so proud of all of us. It's been a great journey till this upcoming day. All the early mornings and long nights wasn't easy at all. Virtual was never how I expected to spend my senior year, but it wasn't nothing I couldn't conquer or we couldn't. We had to make the best of it over a computer screen. Over these past few years, we have not only grown individually, but together as well, and I believe we have formed one of the most successful graduating class at Cheney has ever seen. Even though high school is high school, we all had our ups and downs, but that's okay. We still made it through every struggle. We are all going to have some amazing futures no matter what path we choose in life. We have the power to be anything in life, just never give up on yourself. 4 years ago, I never thought I would be standing here today giving this speech out, but here I am, strong and proud. Cheney has shown me never to give up, have faith, and never to take on an argument with Ms. Weems. Class of 2021 is incredibly strong, and I wouldn't change a thing about my graduating class. Now it's time for new beginnings, because your struggle today is developing the strength you need for tomorrow. Always remember where you came from and always remember where you are going. Don't cry because it's over. This is a new chapter of life. And always remember, we only have one life, so live it to the fullest. I had some great times at Cheney High School. Now I'm going to go see what college is like. Grandpa, this was all for you. Woo, we made history. The CH way. Class of 2021, signing out.
Hello, and congratulations to the Cheney High School class of 2021. My name is Clarence Howe, and I'm also a very proud Cheney Cowboy. I graduated with the best class in Cheney High School history, the class of 2005. You and your families should be very proud of your accomplishments thus far. I would encourage you to give them a hug for helping you to get to this point. I would also encourage you to hug or to elbow bump your siblings, your administrators, your friends, and your teachers, because they've also had a vested interest to get you to this moment. Just in the last 30 seconds, I'm sure you could visualize several people who have played a part in your success thus far. Each time you reach this goal, or you reach a goal in life, I would encourage you to go through this exercise and to think about those who helped you to get there. I would also encourage you to reach out to them to share your gratitude. Don't take those who care about you for granted. There's a popular term, a popular myth, and I'm sure we've all heard it at some point in our lives. This idea of someone being self-made. As I grow older, the more I despise this myth. I can stand before you today and tell you with complete certainty that the idea of someone being self-made is indeed false. There is no such thing as a self-made success story. The reality is that it takes a village to raise a child, and I'm a product of this system. I'm here before you today because of my village. I've been able to achieve some truly amazing things because of them collectively. There are nearly 500 people that have played a major role in my story. Mentoring, listening, coaching, encouraging, teaching, and nurturing me so that I could be all that I was called to be. This village philosophy is how every one of you, and me included, can be successful. And this is how we can ensure that those around us are successful as well. Nobody wins when only you win. I'll say it again. Nobody wins when only you win. The best strategy that we have To see ourselves out of the various crises that we face today is this concept of community. We have to develop a mindset that leads us to build with others, for others, and not solely for ourselves. We have to learn from the events in history, and more importantly, we have to use history to do better. It's our job to pick up the baton from the generation before us and to ready the table for those coming after us. It's up to us to dream and to build the world that we want to live in the world we want our children to live in the world we want their children to live in. This philosophy of community will be at the cornerstone of my message today. I won't be before you long, but there are four challenges that I would like to leave you with as you navigate away from the refuge of this institution. The first is to reach out to those coming alongside you and to reach back to those coming after you. Sankofa. The African proverb of Sankofa translates to reach back. Sankofa is illustrated as a bird reaching for an egg on its back. This gesture symbolizes an older, wiser bird carrying and nurturing an unborn bird. As you reach one major plateau after another in life, reach out and reach back. Don't wait until you reach a certain age, obtain a certain certification or qualification, a certain economic or social status. Your life experience, your thoughts, your ideas, your work ethic, your passion, and your story have value right now. A combination of these nouns has the power to change your reality and the reality of those around you. There is something great that lives inside of us, but we just have to be willing to commit to venture deep inside ourselves in order to unlock our potential. This lifelong voyage to unlock our potential is a humbling one. At times, this journey can be lonely, uncertain, unforgiving, and downright scary. But when you experience a breakthrough, you feel a tremendous amount of joy, fulfillment, pride, and a hunger for more. In my journey, I found myself lost, confused, and unsure if I was going in the right direction or even doing the right thing. Each time I found myself venturing down this path, someone from my village was there to reach out, reach back, and to lift me up. Through a hug, a pickup game of basketball, a road trip to a new place, a barbecue at their home, a haircut, retail therapy at the mall, or an encouraging word. One of the most profound messages that I ever heard was from my track coach at Cheney. Don't be afraid to be great. I'd like for you all to think about that for a second. Don't be afraid to be great. I'll even remix it for you. Don't be afraid to achieve greatness. This simple phrase opened Pandora's box in my life and has propelled me to always, always strive for greatness in whatever I do. This is my second challenge for you today. In all you do, don't be afraid to be great. What does greatness look like for each and every one of you? It's a great question. A great question that only you can define and that only you can answer. Only you have the power and the agency to define what success looks like in your life. I'll say it again. Only you have the power and the agency to define what success looks like in your life. Don't let someone else define success for you. Those around us, they can only aid us on this journey, but it's up to us to own the desires of our hearts. If you do not define success, the world will do it for you. If you do not define what success means and looks like for you, you'll find yourself lost in the midst of a never-ending battle with the internet. And its unrealistic, unsustainable, unattainable, and immoral standards set by people who only care about themselves. The internet and social media have created a world of falsehoods, fueled by a culture of shorts, short videos, ticks and talks, hacks, and this idea of instant success. On Instagram, Snapchat, TikTok, and Facebook, algorithms feed us and flash images of luxury, of leisure, and abundance day in and day out. The sentiment is oftentimes, just follow what I did and you can be here too. It also implies a straight and narrow path to their version of success, or that there are shortcuts that can achieve, that can help you to achieve anything. This subliminal or conscious messaging is both dangerous and completely false. I'm here today to tell you that there are no shortcuts in life. This is my third challenge for you today. Do not believe in or fall into the trap that there are shortcuts. Anything great or anything worth having in life will take your heart, your mind, your hands, and most importantly, it will take your time. Here's an example. Let's look at the life story of the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. If we follow his life through the lens of popular media, his story is summarized to his "I Have a Dream" speech and to his assassination. But his life was much, much deeper than this. Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was the son of a Baptist preacher who succeeded his father-in-law as pastor of one of the most prestigious churches in the city of Atlanta. He was groomed from a young age to follow in his father's footsteps. His village included scholars, clergy, community leaders, thinkers, and doers. And at the tender age of 15, he was enrolled at Morehouse College. Upon graduation, he went on a seminary at Crozier Theological Seminary Institute in Chester, Pennsylvania. After receiving his master's degree, by the age of 26, he went on to achieve his doctorate from Boston University. Upon graduation, he moved to Montgomery, Alabama, where he became the pastor of the Dexter Avenue Baptist Church. And in this moment, Dr. King was ushered into the fight for civil rights. He was again surrounded by some of the best and brightest men and women of that generation, including organizers, strategists, educators, actors, singers, and the top influencers from across the country. They poured into him so that he could become the spokesperson for the civil rights movement and to help to connect the dots to freedom. His journey and those in his village are responsible for us being able to attend the schools we attend, to vote, and to have a chance at having a future. There are two purposes for this story. First is to highlight his life's work, his village, and the significance and the outcome of his life story. The second is to emphasize that there are no shortcuts to achieving anything great. Social media success is like an iceberg. They only show us what's above the surface, the tip of the iceberg. But in reality, 90% of the iceberg, 90% of the surface of an iceberg happens to be below the sea level. Don't let the 10% dictate how you approach the 90%. My fourth and final challenge is the most significant, and of course, it's the most difficult. To practice radical love. Radical love can take on many forms and can have many meanings. The idea of radical love that we'll explore today is a philosophy rooted in loving each other. loving each other in both our words as well as in our actions, no matter the circumstances. It takes a special kind of inner peace, an extreme amount of self-control, and a supernatural amount of patience to be able to deploy this philosophy in our everyday lives. I would not do this occasion and this space justice to not address the obvious. On the other side of those doors of Cheney High School, the world is a crazy and unforgiving place. Even with looking beyond the challenges of COVID-19, we, and I'm putting the emphasis on we're dealing with racism, with mass incarceration, with apartheid, and with classism, just to name a few. There's a lot of darkness on the other side of those doors, but there are also pockets of light. We all have the power of choice, and we can choose to use this power and this authority to move toward darkness or to move toward light. It's up to us to decide where we go. Today, I encourage you to move toward light. Quoting the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. Hate cannot drive out hate. Only love can do that. Choosing to express love in the face of hate is powerful. Choosing to stand up for justice in a world full of injustice is powerful. Choosing to give your time, your talent, or your money to someone in need is powerful. Choosing to reach out and to reach back to others is powerful. Choosing to be great for yourself and for your community or for your village is powerful. Choosing not to believe or to take shortcuts is powerful. Choosing to love your neighbor radically is powerful. Choosing to do all of these things every day is not only powerful, but it's life-changing. Not only for you, but for those who we dwell in the world with together. I challenge you all to be life-changing. I thank you for allowing me to be here with you today. It was truly an honor to be in your company. Thank you. God bless you. And once a cowboy, always a cowboy.
Jovan Adams. Trisha Augusta. Deandre Allen. Mariah Eltrenche. Joe Alvarado. Congrats. Tyler Anthony. Kanique Ashley. Heaven Aubrey. Javen Aubrey. Shamia Bates. Eric Babs. Emily Bell. Theogenic Belton. Isaac Bethel. Fabian Bledsoe. Jalen Boykin. Asia Branch. Kaya Brooks. Aaron Brown. Derek Brown. Xavier Brown. Seth Buchan. Aaliyah Bush. Anaya Calhoun. Ileana Castro. Willadel Cordero Santisteban. Maitwan Cottle. India Dabney. Bryant Douglas II. Jeremiah Douglas. Tymark Freeman. Jalon Gibson. Gigi Gonzalez. Godzinas. Mercedes Guzman. Victoria Harrison. Paisley. Tylen Hawthorne. Adriana Hines. Tyra Huggins. Darius Humbert. Congratulations. Shakira Ift. Jalen Ift. Keziah Jackson. Jason Jackson. Cameron Jackson. Tilden Johnson. Colin Jones. Yeah. Jeffrey Jones. Quincy Jones. Rodney Kelly. Lucas Kreidler. Malcolm Lambert. Cameron Lawrence. Christian LeBron. Dakota Lloyd. Caitlin Marquez. David McLean. Naylee McLean. Matthew McConnell. Shaylin McElroy Banks. Mariana Merck. Kanasia Moncrief. Adriana Montenez. Nevaeh Neal. Jacob Nieves. Leilani Ortello. Gianna Paris. Christian Perez Lopez. Raheem Perkins. Talasia Phillips. Justine Pletcher. Jamal Pusey. Samantha Rivalstein. Rebels. Beau Ripple. Jose Rivera. Janasia Robinson. Lucas Rudloff. Jakiah Rushton. Tariana Rushton. Aviana Scott. John A. Simmons. Jonathan Simmons. Harry Sims. Jemiah Smith. Aaron Stoddard. De'Asia Taylor. Sherrod Taylor. Gage Thomas. Karima Thomas. Janine Trash. Kanaya Uppool. Luis Vasquez. Adeline Walker. Chris Wallace. Naeem Ward. Jatasia Warren. Alexander Watson. Raylan Weaver. Amir Whipple. Lamir White. Zaniah Whitman. Chantel Wilkie. Nevaeh Williams. Altemius Woods. Thank you. Cassia Workman. Aisha Nguyen. Greetings to the Cowboy Nation. I want to start out by congratulating you for your resiliency and perseverance in reaching this milestone during this unprecedented school year. You truly did it with commitment, honor, and service. March 12th, 2020 is one of those days I'll remember for the rest of my life. It's one of those milestones in your life where you'll always remember where you were at and what you were doing. Our graduates were in the third marking period of their junior year. That was our last quote-unquote normal day of school. We were getting ready to have a clap out for our basketball team that was headed to regional basketball championships in Canton. And that's when we got the call that our lives and our world were about to change. As we reflect back, so many things have happened since our first days of staying at home to be safe and social distancing. Although we spent a year sheltered in place, our world did not stop. Our students, our community, and our country has changed in so many ways since those first days of the lockdown. So much happened during your senior year. Tomorrow will mark the one-year anniversary of George Floyd's murder, an event that sparked an outcry for social justice in every corner of our nation, an event that made waves throughout the world. An event that forced Americans and Cheney students to talk and think differently about their own history. This wasn't just all talk. Things happened and things changed during your senior year. The world is different now. Statues and monuments that stood for decades have fallen. My hope is that this was to make room for new heroes and new role models. And my dream is that Cheney students will be these new role models and new heroes for our communities and our nation. Each and every one of you has it in you to impact the future of your family and your community in a positive and meaningful way. This does not mean that you have it all figured out yet. No one expects high school graduates to have it all figured out. But what we need you to know is that you have it inside you. It's in each and every Cheney graduate. It's in each and every senior. There's something that exists inside you to make an impact and to change your world, your life, your family. It's inside you, and we need you to know that it's in there, and we need you to start thinking about how you're going to use that as you move forward. I chose your graduation speaker for a reason. Clarence Howell, or Clay as my family knows him, was so similar to many of you. When he walked across this exact same stage 16 years ago to become a Cheney graduate, he was just like all of you. He didn't have it figured out yet. He knew something was special inside him that could make an impact, but he didn't have it all figured out. Now he's an amazing husband, amazing father, and a leader in his workplace, and a volunteer in his community who believes in pulling up those around him. He impacts his family and his community and makes them all better each and every day. Please know that this exists inside each and every Cheney graduate. Please know you have the ability to impact your family, your community, and the world. Students, I'm going to end today with one last quiz. This quiz goes as follows. What are the words that are inscribed above the stage in the Cheney Auditorium? What are those words? Graduates from all over the country still ask if that inscription is still there above our stage. It's important to them. It's important to Cheney graduates. That's right. It says, enter to learn, go forth to serve. Graduates, you now share the bond of this phrase with thousands of Cheney graduates from all over this city, all over this country, and all over this world. Some have gone on to discover comets. Some have won Heisman trophies. Others are heart surgeons. Some are nurses. and some are engineers. Each and every one of you will serve your community in different ways. Service is an attitude about life that relies on the basic assumption that we are all somehow connected to each other. We are, and you are, all connected now as Cheney Cowboys. You entered to learn, now go forth to serve. Students, I have one last remaining surprise for you. One more speaker that has been with you since the start of your Cheney journey, going back to the first days of Summer Bridge just before your freshman year started. Your freshman principal told you that she would be with you all the way through, that she would be with you on the stage when you graduated. Cowboys come through for each other because you're connected. Miss Ebony Williams is here, and she will share a few words with you. Thank you.
It feels like yesterday when many of you stepped foot in the T for the first time, but you've come a long way since Freshman Fridays. Then we tried to make sure you were ready to go upstairs. Since then, the goal has been to prepare you for the real world. In spite of a global pandemic, with the help of your families and dedicated Cheney staff, you have reached the door to your tomorrows. Please remember that you have a village of people who believe that what you have to offer the world is necessary and important. For the last time, I'll tell you to walk and talk, because you have many things left to do. Congratulations and best luck in your next steps. Once a cowboy, always a cowboy.
Greetings and thank you on behalf of the Youngstown City School District's Board of Education. Thank you to the parents, faculty, and staff for supporting our graduates throughout their journey here in the Youngstown City School District. And congratulations to the class of 2021. The Board of Education has put together a joint message to inspire you and to encourage you in your years to come. Every speech about achievement you have heard and will ever hear will sound the same. What will be different is how you respond to it. Will you live up to the challenge? Will you continue to work hard?
Will you look deep into yourself and find the spirit to persevere when everything seems to be against you? Will you learn the lessons that resilience teaches and be better off for the experience?
All in all, no achievement comes easy. Even though some of you may have talent and skills that make the journey easier than it is for others, achievement is based on potential that has been realized.
This realization is only created through work and sacrifice. Work and sacrifice that will often go unnoticed. However, the knowledge and experience gained will make you prepared for your calling.
As you continue to reach for your goals and dreams, you'll notice that they may change or become different. This isn't a problem. Problems come with regrets for not attempting to achieve a goal and dream.
What will be the story that you will tell about your achievements? Will it contain phrases like, "I wish I would have," or will it be, "I took a chance and this is what I experienced"? Doesn't the latter sound more exciting and intriguing?
When we see you years from now, intrigue us with your accomplishments. Come back and share how the journey of achievement has impacted your life and impart your wisdom upon others. On behalf of the Youngstown City School District's Board of Education, we thank you, we encourage you, and we support you. We wish you the best in your future endeavors. Thank you.
Congratulations, class of 2021. You made it. When you started this journey many years ago, you or we had no idea that it would be a pandemic, that you would be learning from home, sports would be canceled, or seasons would be abbreviated, and your chance to win a state championship would be eliminated. But you still had to test, right? Well, I live by the mantra, the difference between a stepping stone and a stumbling block is the way you use it. Class of 2021, you didn't trip, you didn't falter. You bound over the stone like a Marvel superhero. I want to encourage you to keep bounding, keep climbing. Like COVID-19, there are many obstacles in your way, But as a graduate of Youngstown City School District, you have something in your bloodline. It's called perseverance. In closing, I would like to leave you with the timeless words from the great philosopher, Tupac Shakur. He says, "Remember one thing, through every dark night, there's a bright day after. So no matter how hard it gets, stick your chest out, keep your head up, and handle it." Thank you, and congratulations, class of 2021.